So in this video, we are going to talk about inheritance, one of the most important topic of object-oriented programming when it comes to Java. Many, you know, people in interview ask you questions about inheritance and what are the types of inheritance. So basically, we will not talk about programming language, we will just talk about inheritance first. So inheritance is basically, you know, taking something from parent. Not in parent of terms of, you know, like parents and children. It is basically, you know, acquiring some characteristics of the parent. Like, for example, if two people have curly hair, there are high chances that the child they bear will also have curly hair. So this is like, you know, taking inheritance. So when it comes to programming language, whenever a class wants to, you know, take away the properties of variables or method, we use inheritance concept. Okay, so now we will exactly see what inheritance is. So for example, if you have two classes, class A and class B, so class A is the parent class and class B is the child class. So when child B acts as child class, it is able to inherit methods and variables from class A. We use the concept of inheritance when we, you know, we want to not write methods and variables again and again, or, you know, we want to have a specific class, all the methods and variables available for class A to provide to it. Class B can inherit from class A. In addition, it can have also its own variables and methods. Aisa nahi hai ki class A mein agar 5 variable aur 5 method hai, to class B mein bhi 5 method aur 5 variable honge. Ye duplication hoga. Inheritance is something else. You can have what they have, you know, what they can give to you. In addition, you can also add your own variables and methods. So this is how inheritance works. So now, for example, if I have a class A with name, phone number, age, and gender, and later I have a class B with name, phone number, age, and gender, and employee ID in addition, you can see these four variables are same. Over here, I have in addition of employee ID. So what I can do is that I can go like class B extends class A. Okay, so when I do that, I will be able to, you know, remove these four. Okay, so if, for example, if I want to have like hundreds of class B's like this, so I can actually save space of 400 variables. So when we think about inheritance, it is a very good concept, and it saves lot of space. It, you know, allows you to do multiple things with it. Now we will see what are the types of inheritance. So over here we have three types of inheritance in Java. If we not include the one with interfaces, we have single, we have multi-level, and we have hierarchical. Okay, now we will see each, you know, there's no much difference in them, the concept is same. This is the only concept inheritance follows. Like class B will be able to, you know, inherit variables and methods from class A. But the thing is that when it comes to single, multi-level, hierarchical, the way they extend the classes, this is how we will be able to differentiate them in single, multi-level, and hierarchical. So when it comes to single, we have a class A. This is the parent class. Then a class B extends the class A. This is just a single level. एक क्लास को एक्सटेंड कर रही है. ओके, नाउ वी हैव मल्टी लेवल. ओके, मल्टी लेवल इज लाइक क्लास ए इज पेरेंट ऑफ क्लास बी एंड क्लास बी इज पेरेंट ऑफ क्लास सी. सो व्हाट एग्जैक्टली हैपेंस ओवर हियर इज क्लास बी कैन इनहेरिट ऑल द मेथड्स एंड वेरिएबल्स फ्रॉम क्लास ए. क्लास सी can inherit methods and variables from both class A as well as class B. So basically class C is inheriting two classes. We do multi-level inheritance when we want to provide more specification in the classes as we go down the level. Then later on, we have hierarchical inheritance. It is when we inherit a single class, okay, like class A is parent to class B, class A is parent to class C, class A is parent to class D. Okay, now for example, if we have employees in a company, this is manager, this is engineer, and this is accountant. They all three will belong to same company. They all will have a variable name as salary. They all will have a variable name as employee ID. Additional to that, according to their job role in the company, they will be having more, categorization. Like, okay, the manager will be having a managing board. Engineer will be having his or her own projects he or she is working on. And, accountant will be looking after the classes. But they all three belong to a same company. So this is how hierarchical, inheritance works. Okay, and so this is how inheritance works, and the main benefit of having inheritance is that you don't have to write a specific code again and again. Like if you have declared specific methods and variables class A, and if you are just writing the word extend, you do not have to write the whole specific code again and again. So this is how inheritance helps us, and also remember that inherit class can only derive what is public in class A. If something has kept been private in class A, class B, C, and D won't be able to inherit it. So basically, this is parent class and these three are child classes. That was it. It comes to inheritance. Thank you for watching.